Nous allons aborder maintenant la troisième
Talk about the third planetary boundary that we've exceeded, and this is related to two major biochemical cycles, that of phosphorus, that of nitrogen, both being closely linked to our farming activities, those activities that allow us to feed ourselves. So we talked about another biochemical cycle, that of carbon, over a long period of time. Here we're talking about life, but the consequences are already very significant. These disturbances to the cycle are increasing the number of anoxic environments on the planet, and if it were to change in magnitude, that would be quite concerning. So this is the third limit or boundary that we've exceeded. So let's talk about a fourth boundary that we have exceeded again, and that was not the case back in 2009 when the first paper was published by Rockström, but this is now the case with the publication of Will Stephens' paper, and that's about land use and deforestation. Deforestation of the Amazonian forest, for instance, which was regulating the global rainfall system, and this has a significant impact on the rainfall regime, and it changes it. And once again, we've exceeded a threshold which has a systemic impact, even though less than when we talked about biodiversity and climate. So that's the fourth boundary that we've exceeded. Now, with regards to the other limits, either we've not exceeded them yet, or we do not know how to determine the boundary itself. For freshwater consumption, there are thousands of cubic kilometers of freshwater available for life, and for the out of these 15,000 cubic kilometers, we don't want to exceed 4,000 cubic kilometers so that the rest of life can persist. At the moment, we are at 2.6, but if we look at the trends, and because of an increase in global demography, because of an increase in our economic activities, and because of an increase in plantation, all this could lead us to exceeding this set boundary for human boundaries, and we could go up to 4.6 million cubic kilometers of freshwater consumed by humankind. So this boundary has not yet been exceeded, but we can easily imagine we could exceed it in the upcoming decade. Another boundary, and there again, there is no way we can quantify it. In Rockström's paper, we were talking about chemical pollution, but in Stephen's paper, published in 2015, we're talking about introducing foreign material, because it's not just chemical pollution, it can be heavy metals, it can be other things, such as radioactivity, nanoparticles, etc. We introduce in our biosphere, we introduce foreign elements, and we know that they can have an impact, but we are not in a position to determine the threshold as of which these perturbations would have a dangerous effect on the planetary system. Then another boundary is the destruction of stratospheric ozone. That's part of the overall deterioration that we started experiencing in the 80s. With the Montreal Protocol, we reduced our emissions.
but limite, mais
there again, we've not exceeded the boundary. We've even reduced our deteriorations. Out of the 9 boundaries, it's the only one that we can look at being slightly more optimistic. The emission of aerosols in the atmosphere that can be of industrial origin, agricultural origin. These are small aerosols that send part of the solar energy back into space and reduces photosynthesis slightly, but still has a reduction impact. At the moment, it's the south that's mostly responsible for the emission of aerosols in the atmosphere, and as these have a negative impact on human health, it is not absurd thinking that we'll manage to reduce these in the upcoming decades, but we will also lead to a slight increase on global warming and greenhouse effects. Last boundary that we've not exceeded as yet is about ocean acidification. That's a direct consequence of climate change, and that would be the consequence of the change in the chemical composition of the atmosphere. Carbon oxide is acidic, and it slightly modifies the pH of the oceans, and if we were to continue on the same tracks, we would eventually intensify and fragilize some of the components of the marine trophic chain, because we would prevent structuring organism to structure the oceans. So that's the last boundary that we've thought of, and this is summarized in this table. That's the overall situation for these 9 boundaries. In green, that's what we should not exceed because of the various uncertainties. Then there is the danger zone and uncertainty zone, that's the yellow area, and you see that it's been exceeded in 4 areas, and even for some of these areas, like the perturbation of the nitrogen and phosphorus cycle, the quantity of nitrogen is twice what it would be without human activities. And if you look at carbon dioxide, we've only added 40% additional carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So it's not the same order of magnitude. But here, with this perturbation of the biochemical cycles, it's a shorter cycle, whereas carbon dioxide has a very long cycle. So beyond these zones of uncertainty, we know that the shift is dramatic, and this is what we have in red. We've done that for genetic diversity, and we've done that for the biogeochemical cycles for phosphorus and nitrogen. So this pattern is more nuanced than that of 2009, where only 3 boundaries had been exceeded, and here we have 4 boundaries that have been exceeded out of 9. For 3 of them, we can't define the threshold. So if we were to look at these indicators, we've really shifted into a different system. We've really shifted to Anthropocene.